Hello, everyone, and welcome to this Interpreter's Reveal. My name is Katty Kauffman, and I am a conference and court interpreter. And today I've teamed up with the fabulous folks at T.E.A. Language Solutions to demo the simultaneous interpreting feature recently released by WebEx. Now, we'll get to the hands-on part in just a minute, but spoiler alert, for those colleagues who've been working on Zoom throughout the pandemic, the controls on WebEx will look very familiar. There is a major difference, though, and that is this. On WebEx, you can hear your partner and give and take relay right there on the platform, and there's even a handover feature. But before we get into the nitty-gritty of how the platform works, how the RSI function works on WebEx, let's talk about what we'll need. Now, as an interpreter who's been working throughout this COVID-19 crisis on Zoom and other platforms, you won't need anything special. You need the same computer, the same professional microphone, and same quiet space that you've been using all along. Of course, you will want to download the WebEx app. Although you can use the feature in the browser, it doesn't come with all the bells and whistles. So go ahead and download that client. And speaking of clients, your client, the host for this meeting, will need a basic paid account, not a free one. And they'll also need to learn how to configure this feature. And that can still be a little bit challenging. It's not as straightforward as it is on Zoom, so there will be a learning curve there as well for your client. One other thing to take note of, colleagues, if you've gotten in the habit of teching your own event, that is to say, being the host and being the interpreter, be advised, this will not work on WebEx. At least for now, you can't be both the meeting host or co-host or panelist and the interpreter. It's one role or the other. Also, colleagues, take note, you cannot rename yourself once you're logged in. So make sure that your account is showing a professional name like INT or interpreter plus your language combo. Now, how does this work? Well, in a fashion very similar to Zoom, in fact. As an interpreter, you will receive an email from WebEx advising you that you have been assigned. You click on it and you log in. Now, if you don't have your own WebEx account, that's fine. You can join as a guest. You'll have to put in your name and the same email address that you received the invitation at. This is very important. You will automatically be assigned to your pre-configured interpreting channel with that email address. If you don't log in from the same account, then the host will need to add you to the roster manually. It absolutely can be done, just like it can be done on Zoom, but not everyone will know how to do it. Again, WebEx in that sense is a little more complicated than the feature for those of us who are used to doing it on Zoom. Also remember the following. If you use that interpreter's link to connect to the meeting, you will go straight to that channel. So there's no chit-chatting with a host or the speaker, and also no opportunity for you to explain how that channel works. You'll automatically be right there on it. So let's check it out. And here we are on the WebEx interface for simultaneous interpretation. Now, we can see that several people have been labeled as interpreters, and if we go down to the participant list, we can see exactly what's going on. We have three interpreters, all of whom are muted right now. We have two in Spanish, Spanish to English, or English to Spanish, Spanish to English. They can toggle back and forth. We'll look at that in just a minute. And one interpreter for now who is going to be going from French into English. And again, we can see them listed following best practices nomenclature on screen. But where are my toggles? What do I do as an interpreter? Well, the first thing I'm going to do is go down here to this little globe and click on interpretation. With that, my toggle panel will appear. One nice thing on WebEx is that I can drag it and drop it to put it in a position that's more comfortable for me. Of course, I can toggle back and forth between my languages, and you can see that my microphone is open and unmuted. For the purposes of this demo, I'll go ahead and keep it off. But obviously, if I were interpreting, I would need to turn it on when it's my turn. So let's look at this other controls feature. Well, the first thing that we have here is something that says hand off to next. This is a handover feature, and it's very straightforward. If I'm the active interpreter, I press hand off to next, and I get a pop-up indicating that I should send the request to my colleague. When I click on that, that request goes out. When my colleague accepts that request, their microphone will automatically turn on. Now, mine will not automatically turn off. I need to remember to mute my microphone myself when the handover is complete. Let's see what happens when it goes the other way. My partner has sent me a request, and I'm going to go ahead and accept. As you can see, my microphone has turned on automatically. Now, some colleagues on some operating systems have reported getting a pop-up saying when they've done the handover that the handover is complete and that they should mute their microphone. This does not happen on all operating systems. As you can see, I did not get that message when I handed over to my colleague. So do be aware that you will need to mute your own microphone once you've completed the handover. So we now have an English speaker on the floor, and I will be working into Spanish. But my colleague is on. It's my colleague's turn to interpret. And I want to monitor what is going on. I want to hear my partner, and I want to hear the original audio. I can do that by selecting Spanish, and in this case, I can adjust the volume, my incoming audio mix, from the original audio, just hearing the speaker, or I can move all the way down and just hear my colleague or select something in between. Now the audience has a similar sliding function and feature, so they can do the same thing. They can boost up the volume of the interpreter so they hear the floor a little bit less or vice versa. Very nice feature on the WebEx platform. Now if you're in a bilingual meeting, that's pretty much all you need to know, toggling between your languages and being able to hear your booth mate. But as we saw, there's a French interpreter on the line here. What if we have a second, a third, a fourth language that's going to be spoken on the floor? How does that work? How do I use Relay on WebEx? As we can see, we now have a French speaker on the floor. Now, if I don't have French in my combination, I obviously will be working, I still need to work into Spanish. What I will do is this. I can see that my French colleague is going from French into English, so I can quickly scroll down here, pick English, and then select to hear primarily the interpreter, and that way I will hear only what the French to English interpreter is saying. I can continue to follow along when that presentation is over, and then I can switch it back and be hearing my booth mate. Now, there is one little thing that you need to be aware of here. And that is that I can only hear colleagues who share a language with me. So if I'm in English, Spanish, Spanish, English, I can't eavesdrop, for example, on the colleagues working in the Portuguese to Arabic combination just for fun. I can only listen to people who are working into either English or Spanish because those are the languages that I have been assigned to. And that's how the function works here on WebEx. Before I sign off, one last thing. Remember that seeing your partner is just as important in the online world as it is on site. With WebEx, you won't have to hear them on a back channel, but you will still need that second device to be able to see your booth mate. Even with a handover feature on WebEx, things will go much more smoothly if you can see your partner. And as always, you'll know if they've stepped away right when your system freezes because, well, Murphy and Murphy's Law are real. Things will go wrong. And it's important that you have a full understanding of what's going on in your interpreting environment. Thanks for watching. Have a great day.